I want to bring in our senior political analyst, Gloria Borger. And Gloria, you were watching this, you were listening to this. Give us a sense of the response. I mean, how did the crowd respond to her message?
She was clearly very well received, as you saw. And today's event, not only just O'Donnell, but all of the speakers were really embracing all of those Tea Party themes that we've heard so much about during this campaign season already. Anti-big government, anti-health care, anti any kind of bailout. But the thing that was interesting about what we just heard from O'Donnell was this class warfare argument, the us versus them, which we hear a lot from Sarah Palin.
Sure.
And it's about the elites don't understand us. O'Donnell talked about the anti-Americanism of the so-called ruling class. It's not as if the cultural issues have disappeared at the Value Summit. They're still there. A lot of talk about don't ask, don't tell. But they kind of have been supplanted at this point by the Tea Party themes of anti-big government and us versus the elites in Washington.
I'm very curious as to what you think about how the Republican contenders potentially for 2012 are shaping their own message. I want you to take a listen to Mitt Romney and Rick Santorum and how they put it. Interesting how he married the two, values and small, minimal government here. I mean, that's fascinating.
Family, small government, American values.
What do you think is the challenge for the main Republican contenders?
Well, I think just what you heard today, they've got to figure out a way to capture the enthusiasm of the Tea Party voters without, in a general election, look like they're captives of the Tea Party voters. And it's going to be a very difficult thing for someone to do because the Tea Party demands you to be ideologically pure to a certain degree. And when you run in a general election as a Republican, you don't want to become Barry Goldwater. You know, you want to be able to win. The person I think back to is Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan, remember, he was able to capture Christian conservatives when he was probably the most secular president we've known in our lifetime. And that was because he was optimistic and open and welcoming. And I think that kind of a candidate in the Republican Party would be able to do both. Clearly, Mitt Romney was trying to do that today.
Sure.
Maybe Rick Santorum, who knows? Sarah Palin is the natural here.
I'd be very curious if the Tea Party actually existed during the time of Ronald Reagan, how he would do. And I wonder, how is the Tea Party positioned in the Republican Party? Is it really the center of power?
Well, right now,
for 2012?
Well, we don't know yet. You know, right now it's clearly at the center of power because we see all these midterm elections, we see these Tea Party candidates, many of them are going to win. I think the key is we're going to have to watch to see how these senators and the Tea Party activists behave during the next couple of years, because people are going to be watching them and say, okay, you're not just an interesting new movement. For example, if they're in charge in one house or the other, how are they going to govern? And people, you know, judge you differently from when you're in charge, from when you're just in the opposition. So I think the jury's out on that.
That is the challenge. And obviously, it's fascinating to watch the Republican Party and the evolution of the Republican Party. So thank you so much.
We're still watching.
Yep. Thanks, Gloria.